With all of the potential that Dragon Ball Xenoverse 3 has in becoming one of the greatest Dragon Ball games of all time, one of the main concepts that Dimps and Bandai ought to include in the next Xenoverse game is the roster and characters listed in Super Dragon Ball Heroes. When you look at Dragon Ball Xenoverse 1 and Dragon Ball Xenoverse 2, it's blatantly obvious that they took the concepts originally produced and made from what once was Dragon Ball Online and simply having to retell that story in the form of introducing Mira, Toa, the Time Patrollers, your own CAC having to become a Time Patroller alongside many other aspects, but we also know that Fuu is a part of the story involving Mira and Toa. In fact, Fuu is actually the offspring of both Mira and Toa to begin with, so by having Fuu be a part of Dragon Ball Xenoverse 3, could we ever get the introduction of Fuu not only going as far as to tamper and upgrade and enhance specific warriors as we've seen in the Super Dragon Ball Heroes anime and manga, but also seeing what we've gotten in the Super Dragon Ball Heroes video game by introducing characters like Cumber, introducing characters like Punished Fuu Zamasu, Hearts, Grand Priest Ultra Instinct Goku, Lags, Kamen, Orin, Kami Orin, Machikabura, Demigra, and so many other playable characters that could be a huge supporting factor in Xenoverse 3. And if you guys have missed out the previous two Dragon Ball Xenoverse 3 videos I've made, we basically discussed the overall concept of why it would be a good idea for Xenoverse 3 to be delayed until 2020, introducing the title, of course, for the next generation consoles, and that being Xbox Scarlet and PlayStation 5, but also discussing the overall potential that Xenoverse 3 has in terms of a good story and a good presentation. And I do think that by including characters like Base Cumber, Super Saiyan 3 Cumber, and many other additions that stack on from what we've seen in Super Dragon Ball Heroes, that would be a good thing going forward, as I do think that if they do decide to make a Xenoverse 3, I think that that in and of itself will be the last Xenoverse game within the series, and if they're going to do that, then why not go out in a bang? But there's always that chance that we might get another repeat of Dragon Ball Z Raging Blast 2, which of course we never had the opportunity to see what it would have been like to have a Raging Blast 3. So this outcome could turn out to be one of two things: either A, we get Xenoverse 3, or B, we don't get Xenoverse 3. But when looking at the overall sales and the dynamic from Xenoverse 2 on the console platforms, on the PC, it sold relatively well, and people do wholeheartedly enjoy the game outside of the broken netcode, RNG, and all the other stupid things that come with the game itself, in which Dimps and Bandai can end up fixing. But I do think that it's a little bit too late, given the fact that in October of 2016, which fundamentally was the original release date for Xenoverse 2, this upcoming October, it'll mark 3 years for the game's release. And with that being said, I think that they need to focus more on what the next game ought to be in terms of graphics, story, multiplayer, gaming mechanics, the engine in and of itself, but also the character roster. So for me, I think it'll be a great idea by introducing the Super Dragon Ball Heroes characters in Dragon Ball Xenoverse 3, considering the fact that in Xenoverse 2 now, we do have certain characters that do fit within Super Dragon Ball Heroes, as of course Goku, Vegeta, Trunks, but also we see Fuu and many other characters that were initially a part of Super Dragon Ball Heroes. So why not go as far as to introduce Super Saiyan Blue Kaioken times 20 Vegito, possibly introducing Super Saiyan 4 Xeno Vegito, Xeno Goku, Xeno Vegeta, characters of that nature, because I do think that with Xenoverse 3, they could give us all of the essential characters that we do see now, especially with the DLC characters having to come in the form of day one packages instead of them having continuous DLC packages for us to buy. Rather, that include all of the characters that we have now in Xenoverse 2 for Xenoverse 3 as day one playable characters, and if they ultimately want to include Moro or any other Super Dragon Ball Hero character, they can do that, because Super Dragon Ball Heroes, Dragon Ball Fusions, introduces the concept of so many different what-if characters. For example, we do have Metal Golden Cooler. We have the concept of Final Form Golden Cooler. There's so much substance in what they could introduce in terms of bringing us different characters, brand new characters, but also having each and every single one of them play differently as well. And a good example of this is separating base Cumber from Super Saiyan 3 Cumber, as of course we've seen in Super Dragon Ball Heroes, as the two variations do seem to have a different fighting style when looking at both of their presentations. And what Dragon Ball Xenoverse 3 ultimately needs to capitalize on is making every single character feel different in their approach. But not only that, let's say for example if there are moves that Golden Metal Cooler have, Super Saiyan 3 Cumber have, Hearts has, Kami Orin has, if there are specific techniques and moves that these individuals possess, they ought to be made accessible to the consumer and players of the game. That way, once they work towards a common goal in unlocking this, they can ultimately get it. But that ultimately also includes fixing the RNG system, which again, we've talked about in the previous videos before. And if you guys agree with all of this, be sure to go on ahead and slap a big fat like down below, because we're unsure right now if there is even going to be a Xenoverse 3 to begin with. And if it's secretly being worked on right now, then I truly do hope they do end up fixing the netcode and introducing concepts and ideas, not just for other characters such as the ones mentioned, but also giving us all of the accessibility in allowing this to be accessible to our own CAC characters. But by the end of it, I do think that they should incorporate elements from Super Dragon Ball Heroes in Dragon Ball Xenoverse 3 and giving us a different dynamic when it comes to the character roster. I mean, sure, you can have Dragon Ball, Dragon Ball Z, Dragon Ball GT, and Dragon Ball Super characters, but how interesting would it be to have different characters outside of the main canon be introduced in Dragon Ball Xenoverse 3, such as Super Saiyan 4 Kaioken Gogeta, the enemy of the Super Dragon Ball Heroes video game, Seelos, and many other characters of that nature? Would it allow Dragon Ball Xenoverse 3 to feel different in terms of its overall presentation and just everything that the game has to offer in terms of value? But I want to get your thoughts in the comment section below about your feelings towards Super Dragon Ball Heroes characters being included. Do you guys think that perhaps this is a good idea, a bad idea? And if we were to introduce various different Super Dragon Ball Heroes characters in the game itself, who would you guys like to see and why? If there are a specific number of characters that you guys would like to see, who would you guys like to see and why? Thank you all so much for watching, guys. Once more, if you guys are new to this channel and love gaming and Dragon Ball, then don't forget to smash that subscribe button, slap a big fat like down below by giving this video a big thumbs up, leave your thoughts in the comment section below, and drop your thoughts in the comments, guys. Thank you all so much for watching. Thank you all so much for listening. Tune back in for the next video, and I'll be seeing each and every single one of you guys down in the comment section below. Have a great day, everybody. Peace.